You just got a package. You're excited about what's inside, but your cat is obsessed with the box. Not just any box, the smallest, most ridiculous, how are you even doing that box? You see them cram, squish, and pour themselves into a space that seems to defy the laws of physics. Are they just being weird? Is it a silly game? Or is your cat's brain tapping into a powerful ancient instinct that you can't see, but is essential to their happiness? The answer is more incredible than you think. In this video, we're going to decode your cat's obsession with tiny spaces. I'll explain why you should think twice about throwing that box away, and I'll give you three simple ways you can use this secret knowledge to make your cat feel safer, happier, and more understood than ever before. So what's actually happening in your cat's mind when they choose a shoebox over their expensive fluffy bed? It comes down to two things: survival instinct and a cool biological phenomenon. First, let's talk about instinct. In the wild, cats are both skilled predators and vulnerable prey. A small, tight space is a perfect tactical advantage. It's a hidden den where they can't be ambushed from the side or behind. From this safe spot, they can watch the world go by, invisible to threats, and perfectly positioned to pounce on unsuspecting prey, even if that prey is just your unsuspecting ankle. And here's a fun twist. You might think this is just a house cat thing, but it's not. Even big cats, tigers, lions, leopards, have been caught on camera at wildlife sanctuaries trying to squeeze themselves into cardboard boxes. Yes, a 400-pound tiger will happily plop itself into the same kind of box your Amazon order came in. Instinct, it seems, doesn't care about size. But there's a more fascinating scientific reason at play, and it has a very specific name. Thigmotaxis. Thigmotaxis is a tendency of an organism to seek contact with objects or surfaces. Think about it like this: when you're in a crowded room, do you feel more comfortable in the wide open middle or with your back to a wall? For many of us, the wall provides a subtle sense of security. Cats take this to the next level. The gentle, constant pressure from the sides of a box, a sink, or even a small basket is deeply calming. It's like a constant, reassuring hug. This pressure is believed to release endorphins, natural feel-good chemicals inside your cat's brain that reduce stress and create a sense of pleasure. Okay, so it's instinct and a bit of brain chemistry, but why does this matter to you and your cat? Because this isn't just a funny quirk, it's a window into their emotional needs. When your cat squeezes into a tiny space, they aren't being antisocial or strange. They are actively seeking comfort and security. In our big, open, human-centric homes full of loud noises and unpredictable movements, a small box can be a sanctuary. It's their safe room, a place where the overwhelming world shrinks down to a manageable size. Understanding this changes everything. You stop seeing a cat in a box and start seeing a brilliant creature managing its own stress. This behavior is a form of self-care. They are telling you, I need to feel secure right now. And by recognizing that, you can move from just being an owner to being a true guardian of their well-being. This empathy is a foundation of a truly unbreakable bond. The power of these small spaces is so profound, it's actually been studied scientifically. In a fascinating study at a Dutch animal shelter, newly arrived cats were divided into two groups. One group was given a simple cardboard box to hide in, and the other wasn't. The results were astonishing. The cats with access to a box showed significantly lower stress levels and adapted to their new scary environment much faster. They recovered from the trauma of the shelter in just a few days, while the others remained highly stressed for much longer. But what happens when this natural, stress-reducing instinct is ignored in our own homes? That's where seemingly small issues can start to build up. So how can we use this knowledge to be even better cat parents? It's easy, we just need to become architects of our cat's comfort. Here are three simple things you can start doing today to support your cat's natural need for secure spaces. 1. The box upgrade. Don't throw away those delivery boxes. Leave a few around the house. Turn one on its side to create a little cave. If you want something more permanent, a small enclosed cat bed or a cat cave made of felt can provide that same sense of security while looking great in your home. The key is that it's enclosed. 2. Create vertical havens. Cats don't just think horizontally. Vertical space is just as important. A tall cat tree with a small higher perch or a walled basket on top can be the ultimate secure lookout point. It allows your cat to feel safe and survey their territory from above, satisfying both their need for security and their instinct to be in control. 3. Respect the retreat. This is the most important tip. When your cat is in their chosen small space, whether it's a box, a sink, or under the bed, treat it as their do not disturb zone. They are there to decompress. Never pull them out or force interactions. By respecting their need for solitude, you are showing them that you understand and protect them, which builds immense trust. So, the next time you see your cat wedged into a fruit bowl or curled up in a shoebox, you'll know the truth. You're not just seeing a funny liquid cat. You're seeing a brilliant mind at work, a creature hardwired for survival, finding its own peace and security in a world that can often feel too big. This isn't just about boxes. It's about understanding that every weird thing that your cat does has a reason. It's a message, and when we learn to listen, we build a connection that is truly special. If you want to keep decoding the secrets of your cat's world and strengthen that bond, make sure you subscribe to Cat Cognition. I have new insights that will help you see your cat in a whole new light every single week. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to sit inside a box.